Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, and today, and forever. The Church of Jesus Christ presents Pastor and Evangelist Pete Rowe.
Thank you, Jesus. All right, we want to thank God. Welcome everybody today to the program. Do appreciate the Lord for this privilege of getting to be with you here today. And we're going to be taking into a message in a little bit now concerning the last day resurrection. And of course, we're going to let you know by the Bible that there was a first resurrection, and also there's going to be a final resurrection. And we do thank God today and want to welcome everybody. And also I want to make this announcement before we get into our message. Lord willing, now that's September the 26th, which is this month. Of course, this is 2008, but Lord willing, now we're going to be in Princeton, West Virginia. And we're going to be with Brother Ronnie Steele and the church up in that area, Church of Jesus, and it's located on the old 460 road, I believe it is. And I'll give you a little bit of the directions right now, and we'll try to get maybe a phone number to give to you in the next week or so. But now that's this September the 26th, which is on a Friday night. We're going to be in Princeton, West Virginia, and the address, you get on 460 at Princeton, and you'll get off the Oakvale and Kellyvale exit, and get off to the ramp, and then you, I believe it is, you turn left after you get off on 0460, I believe it is, and it's about 2 miles, and the church will be right on your right. So we'll give you more information. I'll put it on my internet and so forth, but now it's with Brother Ronnie Steele, and he's the pastor of the church up in the Princeton area. And this will be my first trip up in that area, and we're looking forward. We're gonna believe God for praying for the sick and for the needs of His people, and expect a good meeting to break loose. So we want to invite you, everyone that can in these areas that want to be with us. We hope you can, and we do love God's people, children. And that's this 26th now of this month. That's at Princeton, West Virginia. So if you can, we'll give you a little more detail on my website and so forth. But we do thank God today. And what I'm going to be speaking on now, children, will be concerning now the last day and what really takes place when the Lord does return. And of course, I love teaching on these end time because I know it's here upon us. And that's why Jesus always tells you, watch you therefore and pray always that you're counted worthy to escape the things that's coming up on us. But also, we're going to have to stand before the Son of Man and give an account of the deeds that we do in our body. And what I especially want us to recognize, I want to today read you a little bit out of the book of 2 Kings and about the second chapter now concerning the great prophet Elijah. And of course, if you've read the teachings of Elijah the prophet, in the New Testament he's called Elias. But now there was a successor that God was going to give the authority to take the place of Elijah, and that was Elisha. And the spirit of Elijah would rest upon Elisha. I'll get it in a minute. But anyway, because children, if you study the Bible, the same spirit that was in the prophets and in Elijah is the same spirit of God that's in the church today. And that's why that we have to, there's no getting around it, we have to believe on Jesus Christ according to the prophets and the apostles. Because Jesus gave the apostles His word, and He fulfilled everything that was written in the Old Testament prophets. So you see, you don't get a different spirit than the prophets had, but it's all the same Holy Ghost. And children, believe it or not, it's the same rock, which was the God of the Old Testament, that you and me have to build up on in this New Testament. And Paul said that rock was Christ. So this is going to be what we're speaking on concerning now the coming of our Lord and this final resurrection of the dead. See, now, I know there's a lot of teaching out here and a lot of misrepresenting the resurrection, and some don't even believe we've had a resurrection at all yet, but we're going to be showing you by the Word of God that order of the resurrection and just how it took place, because children, the apostles is the ones that wrote this right, and if we're going to teach or build, we're going to have to build up on them. But now, there's a lot of teaching in the land, and some of you popular teachers too, that's telling the people that there is no future resurrection, that if a person dies, he either goes on into heaven or goes into hell or the second death, and they just kind of deny that there'll be a resurrection of the literal dead people. Now, children, I'm going to show you some of these things and let you know that it's not true. There is a literal raising of the dead. Because every one of us, unless the Lord comes now, it's appointed to die. We have to die. But there is also a raising of the dead. And now, you can read the story of Lazarus. And that was a friend of Jesus, and he had a sister, Martha Mary. And you know the story, how that Lazarus died. He was sick unto death. But thank God, when Martha was talking to Jesus, she told Jesus, if you'd have been here, he wouldn't have died. But said, I know now, whatever you ask of God, he'll give it. And she was asking the Lord for her brother to be rose from the dead. And of course, you know what Jesus told her. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. And told her that her brother would rise again. But now, Jesus did literally raise him from the dead, but now, that wasn't the resurrection of the dead. But there is a final resurrection of the dead. And Martha, she said, Lord, I know my brother will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. So you see, children, the Bible won't go along with teaching. And people that's going around sitting in their little pews and telling the people that there is no resurrection. That's a Sadducee religion. Because, children, even in the book of Revelation, I believe the 14th chapter, John said, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord, for yea, saith the Spirit, that they rest from their labors. Come on. And their works do follow them. So there is a rest, which to Jesus is sleeping. Because the Bible said, don't sorrow even as others which have no hope, in the 4th chapter, 1 Thessalonians. Because Paul said, if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. So children, there is a real resurrection. And I mean literally raising of the dead. But now, I want to show you concerning, first of all, Elijah here. And then, of course, if you get time, you read the book of Hebrews chapter 11 and also the book of Genesis concerning Enoch. Now, he was a man that pleased God, walked with God, and he had such a testimony that God just took him out of here, translated him, that he should not see death. And he was not found. Now, that's one reason that there's no way that Enoch can be one of these future witnesses out of Revelation 11. A lot of people believe the last two prophets that's coming is going to be Elijah and Moses. Some say Enoch and Elijah or Enoch and Moses. But children, you have to study the Word of God to know these things. But now Enoch was translated. But God said that he should not see death, and he was not found, for God took him. So he's with him. He won't be coming back to this earth. And neither will Elijah, and neither will Moses. Because we can show you here in the book of Matthew, I believe the 17th chapter, different places where that when Jesus was getting ready to give his life, he spoke about the Mount of Transfiguration. And there's where Elijah and Moses appeared to him. And if you'll read it out in Matthew 17, we'll get that a little later. Matthew 17, they were in glory. Moses and Elias, and they were in glory. And they were speaking to Jesus concerning his death. He was going to suffer. So you see, children, once you've entered into that glory, you're not coming back. So there's no way Elijah and Moses could be these witnesses. And we'll show you a little bit in the future. But as God is my helper, children, we've seen so much deceiving in the land. People don't even know whether there's been a first resurrection. And be honest with you, most people think it's not happened yet. But we're going to show you these things. But first of all, let me read you something here out of the book of 2 Kings, chapter 2 and verse 1, concerning now Elijah the prophet. And it came to pass when the Lord, verse 1, would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went from Elisha, went with Elisha from Gilgal. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said, listen to this, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went down to Bethel. And the sons of the prophets that were at Bethel came forth to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord would take away thy master from thy head today? And he said, yea, I know it. Hold ye your peace. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho. And he said, listen to this, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they came to Jericho. Now, Elisha had a reason, because he was going to ask a certain thing of the prophet Elijah. And he was going to ask him for a double portion of Elijah's spirit. And you better believe Elijah was a mighty prophet of God. And he's the one that turned the hearts of the children of Israel back toward the God of Israel. And if you remember that story of the Mount Carmel, where he told them, if the Lord be God, serve him. But if Baal, then serve him. So you see, children, there's things in this Bible that God fulfilled for a purpose, but now also there will be a final resurrection of the dead. And I mean literally the dead. And of course the living's going to go through a change at his next coming. And children, we're going to be touching on these things. But in the meanwhile, I want to show you that Elijah here, when he was taken up, now, there ain't no doubt that he had to put off the mortal and go on into immortality. But he wasn't dead when this event happened, and neither was any. Any was very much alive, and he was pleasing to God, and God just up and took him out of here. Now, a lot of them want to use that as a type of the rapture of the church, which is no wise Bible. And neither is Revelation 4, where John was caught up in the Spirit. But see, people need something to try to bring their way of doctrines of the catching away of the saints. But now, if it's not Bible, I'm sorry, it's not going to help us, children. But we do have plenty of Bible concerning the coming of the Lord and the resurrection of the dead. And there's no way God can, take you out of here outside of the way it's written in the book. He can't do that. And there's no Bible telling you that he'll sneak us out of here before the tribulation. And neither during it. It's going to happen after the tribulation. And that's only called up, you're going to read in the Bible. But it don't call it rapture or nothing. But nevertheless, we are going to be leaving here. And a lot of people don't understand it, but we're going to have to go to our Bibles. It don't matter what I say or the pastor say or the preacher, whoever it is. If you can't read it, children, then it's not in there, then why you wouldn't even believe it? You don't believe something you can't read about. See? And we can read now where Elijah was taken up. You can read where Enoch was translated. But also, you're going to be reading about a resurrection. And that's going to be the catching away. The dead in Christ is going to rise first. Then we that are alive and remain are going to be caught up together with them. There's no two judgments here. There's one more appearing, and children, that's going to be it with the Lord. Now, I know the world don't agree with a lot of it, but it's still Bible. Now, watch what happened, though, with Elijah here. Listen to this. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho. And he said, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they came to Jericho. And the sons of the prophets, watch this, that were at Jericho came to Elisha and said unto him, knowest not thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he answered, yea, I know it. Hold ye your peace. So Elisha was hanging around Elijah for a purpose. Now watch this. So he told him to hold your peace. Listen to this now. And Elijah said unto him, tarry, I pray thee here, for the Lord has sent me to Jordan. And he said, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they too went on. Now, verse 7, and 50 men of the sons of the prophets went and stood to view afar off. They knew God was going to take him out of here. And they too stood by Jordan. And Elijah took the mantle, wrapped it together, and smote the waters, and they were divided hither and thither, so that they too went over on dry land. And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, now listen to this, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let me a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. Let a double portion of your spirit be upon me. Now, he's talking about a double portion of the anointing of God that was upon Elijah. And if you remember, God did a lot of miracles through Elijah, raising the dead, healing even the sick back then. See? And he wanted a double portion of his spirit. Now, listen to this. And he said, Elijah said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I'm taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass as they still went on and talked, that behold, now notice this, there appeared a chariot afar and horses afar, and parted them both asunder. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. Now, children, Elijah did not die there. But there is no doubt that he went out of the mortal life of flesh into the glory of God. And that's what's going to happen in the final resurrection now. We are going to be changed if we're alive. And if you're dead and you're in the Lord, you're going to be raised first. And then all of us will be called up to meet the Lord in the air. And children, listen to me. God, help us understand. He never told you the dead would raise and the living change. And I'll go over into Jerusalem, over here in the Middle East. It's not going to be the way the world teaches. Children, we're going to leave here all right, but only to meet the Lord in the air. And that's why Paul said, if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we got a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. And see, that's what we're going to be clothed upon. But this life and this body is made out of the dust of the earth, and according to your Bible, dust you are, dust you return. And a lot of people think you're coming up in the same body. And they say, because Jesus came up in the same body. Well, it's true about Jesus. And the reason Jesus came up in the same body that died is because Jesus was not made out of the dust of the ground like you are. He was coming out of glory as a baby and born in Bethlehem. He took on himself flesh and blood, but children, he came out of glory. And whenever he was speaking there in the 17th chapter of the book of St. John, he prayed and said, Father, glorify thou me with the glory that I had with you before the world was. So you see, the same body that died did rise from the dead. And it's ever in heaven now. But see, as far as you and me, we're in this earthly and we bear that image of the earthly. But if we're worthy of his final resurrection, then we're going to bear the image of the heavenly. And the reason is because flesh and blood and even this corruptible body cannot inherit the eternal glory. That's why we do definitely get a new body. No doubt. But that's all at the last day coming of our Lord. And it's not going to be but a moment of twinkling of an eye. It's not going to be a big prayer line. God put one over here. Honey, as God is my helper. Matthew 25 and verse 31. When the sheep go on his right hand is when the dead in Christ and the living in Christ are changed and called up, 1 Thessalonians 4, to meet the Lord in the air. Right there is the separation from the sheep and the goats. And the goats go on the left hand, which is the lake of fire, and children, that's your second death, and then it's over. But now I'm going to show you, according to your Bible here, Elijah was not resurrected. He was just taken out of here, but he was changed. He entered into glory. And if you want proof of that, go to Matthew 17, because while Jesus was on that mount, there appeared unto him Moses and Elias, which is Elijah, in glory, see? And they spoke to him. So children, you better believe there are angels, there is a heavenly place. You know, it's sad people think that only God there is. And the only life there is on this earth. Children, it's not. There's a better day a coming. There's a better world a coming. And it's completely different, but something people don't understand, all your former things is going to be gone. You'll not know the things you know now, because then you would know the suffering ones. All the former things, everything of this carnality life on earth is over with at that day. And we do inherit a new heaven, thank God, a new earth, wherein it'll be nothing but righteousness. But all that's in the future. But in the meanwhile, listen about Elijah. In verse 7, and 50 men of the sons of the prophets went and stood to view afar off, and they too stood by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle, wrapped it together, smote the waters, and they were divided hither thither, so that they too went over on dry ground. And it came to pass that when they were gone over, now watch this, that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for you before I be taken away from thee. And he said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. Now that's a request of Elisha. And he said, Elijah, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou seest me when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass as they still went on, now watch this, and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot afar, and horses afar, and parted them asunder, and Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. Notice that. And Elisha saw it, and he cried, my father, the chariot of Israel, and the horsemen thereof. And he saw him no more. And he took hold of his own clothes and rent them in two pieces. Now, children, listen to me. Elijah was seen no more in his flesh. But you can read in the book of Malachi, I believe the fourth chapter, where it does mention once again of Elijah. But this time, it would be concerning the anointed spirit that was upon Elijah that would give ability to a man to do what Elijah did in the Old Testament, turn the hearts of the children of Israel toward their fathers. Because when the Spirit leads you to the Word of God, in our day it would be the apostles and prophets, and whenever the Spirit leads you through them, then it's leading you straight to Jesus. Because that's how you build upon the Lord, is upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets. And children, listen to me. In Malachi 4, God said, behold, I'll send unto you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and notable day of the Lord. All right, now, this was fulfilled, as most of us should know, by the birth of another prophet, John the Baptist. And John the Baptist had earthly parents, which was Elizabeth, and his father was Zacharias. And Elizabeth couldn't have no children. But God was going to fulfill his word, and children, listen to me, Gabriel appeared unto Zacharias and told him that Elizabeth would bear a child. Even told him what to call his name, and that child would go before the Lord in the spirit and the power of Elijah. So there's your mentioning of Elijah, but not in his person, but in the spirit of him. Now, I see my time's about up, and I'll get more into these things, but be sure to stay with me, children. I want to show us that there is a coming of our Lord for the final resurrection. So be sure to stay with me in Jesus' good name. And be sure to stay tuned with me, because I'll be telling you a little more about the meeting in Princeton. So God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
We would like to thank you for joining Brother Rowe and invite you to continue with him in outreach. Your prayers and support will be deeply appreciated. If God leads you to help in this ministry, please send your contributions to The Church of Jesus Christ, Post Office Box 283, Baxter, Kentucky 40806. And may God bless you.